How about another hand for our Emerson Faculty and Alumni Orchestra? Good morning and welcome to our 2024 Emerson School 8th grade graduation. Yeah, you can clap, that's okay. You know, I love to watch the faces of our faculty during ceremonies like today. No matter the grade level when we first met today's graduates, each of us feels a deep connection to this class of 2024. We often talk about being educators who teach the whole child. It is this complete commitment to the academic, to the social, and to the emotional development of our students that makes us so successful. And so we are deeply connected to this ceremony today, and I'm so pleased that our colleagues are here to be a part of your celebration. Faculty and staff members, my colleagues, thank you for your boundless energy, your deep dedication, and the full heart you bring to campus each and every day. Most of all, thank you for providing a nurturing environment where students can't wait to arrive, can't stand to leave, and a place where students find teachers who love and respect them as individuals. Family members, you're your child's first teacher. You're there for those first steps, those first words, that first day of school. A milestone like today is only possible because of the care and the nurture that you provide. Thank you for sharing your children with us, for the opportunity to be a part of your child's personal narrative. This day is really a celebration for your whole family. To my friends, the class of 2024, thank you for a year filled with exploration, an occasional challenge here or there, but most of all for your deep curiosity for learning. It's been a privilege to join a community where you as eighth graders serve as leaders. A few years ago, I attended a middle school graduation where a young woman stood at a podium like this and spoke to her class invoking the metaphor of the Roman god Janus. Janus, she said, is that being with two faces, one looking to the past and one looking to the future. As she suggested, middle school graduates find themselves on occasions like today feeling a lot like Janus. You're staring at the middle point of your school life. This ceremony is a moment to pause and look in both directions. It's a chance to reflect and to consider all that's going to come next. To say thank you to the people who are here today to celebrate with you. You see, today we're celebrating the end point of your middle school years with family, with friends, with all the folks who helped guide you to this very special day. As you reflect on your middle school years, I hope you will see the active nature of the learning in which you were involved. Each of you are not only students, you are also mentors, you're partners. You're the big buddies to the younger students who look up to you in the hallways every day. Through the many lab experiences, class debates, quiz bowl competitions, science nights, art projects, music concerts, field days, you've helped each other to learn. You've learned about cooperative learning and the empathy that comes with being part of community. Your leadership as ambassadors, as student council members, as athletes representing Emerson School in competitions, has helped us thrive, and I am so, so proud of you. As we look into the future, you are the class, the high school class of 2028. That's something to think about. Your teachers have helped you to understand the strength and the vitality of community, and you graduate here today with a skill set necessary to think deeply and critically and to lead. You know, in this 50th year of our school, I've thought a lot about the passing of time. Looking at you today, I have this picture in my mind of what things will look like 10 years from now when you come to an alumni celebration. What are you going to be like then? You know, regardless of where you find yourself or what you're doing in your daily life, I hope you will look back at these days and hold on to that curiosity that has driven you. Allow yourself the creativity that's inside to find space for expression. That you're kind and empathetic to the people that you meet. That you're resilient to the challenges that you face. And most of all, that you center your life on integrity. If our school has helped you to contribute to this outlook on life, we will truly be satisfied. And we will know that we have served our purpose to you as educators. I hope your years at Emerson have given you a strong sense of community, that you've internalized values that are dear to you, and that you graduate with meaningful relationships with both friends and adults. If that is so, I know we will never forget each other. I am honored and privileged to say congratulations to the class of 2024. It's my pleasure to introduce to you the chair of the Emerson School Board of Trustees, Mr. Charles Grace.
Good morning, everybody. It's been an honor and privilege for me to serve Emerson as the board chair for the last year. An even greater honor and privilege of mine has been being a dad to three kids who have come through this school, or one who's come through this school as a class of 2023 graduate. So for all the parents that are sitting out there today celebrating their graduates, congratulations. It's an awesome feeling. I was asked to say a few words today, and so I was thinking to myself, what makes graduation ceremony special? It feels like a special day. Everyone's dressed up, or most of us are dressed up, and we're here celebrating something. But why is that a big deal? You know, we live at a time in history where achievement is so incredibly prized in our community and our society, and this is certainly a remarkable achievement, graduating from Emerson School. I know that eighth grade year in particular is a lot of work. Feels like a mountain climb for the graduates. But I think that the reason that graduation ceremonies are so special goes beyond just the achievement inherent in completing this milestone, right? Graduation ceremonies, I think, are special for a different reason. Like all of the graduation ceremonies that have happened over the course of the last several weeks in this world, it's special because it's a recognition of a major transition in life for an entire cohort of people at the same time, a simultaneous ending and beginning, a moment in time that beautifully articulates and helps us all to see the wonder of the human experience in this passage of time in both the individual and the collective's growth. Graduations are special because they encourage us to take a step back and reflect, to go beyond the achievements we all get so focused on in our lives and to consider where we've come from, the road we've traveled, and most importantly, the people that we've become along the way. The young adults who are graduating from Emerson School today have grown tremendously as students, individuals, and humans in the time that they've been in the school. Some of them walked in these doors when they were just 5 years old. They have grown up both literally and figuratively, and that transformation is one of the most incredible parts of the human experience that any of us ever have a chance to witness. What makes this ceremony so special, I think, is that it provides us all with a clear framework for seeing that growth, appreciating its extraordinary dimensions, and celebrating what that means. Soon-to-be graduates, as you go ahead in your lives, schools, and eventually careers, you'll undoubtedly have a myriad of opportunity to acquire an ever more important collection of achievements. You'll do, as you already have done, amazing things. Your foundation at Emerson, I'm sure, will prove to be, I think, a tremendous springboard for you in the way you go forward. And yet, as you go through this life and climb the various mountains in front of you, I'd encourage you to not get so caught up in your next achievement that you miss the opportunities available to you to step back and see where you've come from, how you've grown, and who you've grown with. Today is a special opportunity to celebrate this important transformational moment in this group of young people, but it's not the only opportunity. Each of us, whether an eighth grade graduate or an 80-year-old grandparent, have an opportunity every single day to reflect on where we've been, to remember where we've come from, why we've chosen the path that we're on, and the people who have and continue to help us to get there. Congratulations to the soon-to-be class of 2024. Congratulations to families, friends, relatives. You've achieved something special. I hope that you have continued success in the days, weeks, months, and years ahead. Thank you.
As I said earlier, this year we celebrated our 50th anniversary as a school. We were founded in 1973 by a woman named Jean Navarre. And I'm so pleased and honored to introduce to you Ms. Navarre's son, Dr. William Navarre, an alumnus of our school, who will give some remarks to our graduates. Dr. Navarre.
Well, thanks so much for having me on board today, and congratulations to our graduates today. I'd also very much like to congratulate and acknowledge the families and friends who supported our graduates, who dutifully carted these fine young people back and forth from, you know, home to Scio Church and Zeeb, back to home, back to Scio Church and Zeeb, back to home, multiple times, sometimes several times a day, for many years on end. That is commendable effort, and for some of you, it ends here. For some of you, you have younger kids here, but thank you for putting your faith in Emerson, which my mom started, as he said, 50 years ago. I'd also like to thank the teachers and staff for their efforts and their work with these students. Your work here is critical, invaluable, and really the most important thing that makes Emerson Emerson are the teachers. So thank you very much. All right. I'm just going to talk a little bit about how Emerson got started and then bring it back to something that I think we can all learn from it. There's some facts. I mean, so Emerson started 50 years ago. My mother was born in 1941. That means when Emerson started, she was 32 years old. What you may not know is that she was a high school teacher who was dissatisfied as a high school teacher, and I'll tell you why in a second, but she left her job when she became pregnant with me, was sort of bored and looking for something inspiring in her life, and she started Emerson. Now, who would trust the education of their elementary-aged children to a 32-year-old starting a brand new school in a church basement with 11 other students, or 10 other students, because there was 11 students, is beyond me, but there was a leap of faith there. So my mother, she grew up in Cincinnati, Ohio. She attended Denison University. She graduated in 1962. She taught high school in Ohio for two or three years, English and drama, and she loved her time there. The students and her hit it off. The principal there allowed her to develop her own curriculum and to bring her passion into the classroom. My mom, for her entire life, was never happier than in those 3 years when she was teaching in Cleveland, Ohio, okay? Then she decided she wanted to get a master's. She came here to Ann Arbor, got her master's degree, met my father. Now she's stuck in Michigan. She picks up a job at a Detroit area school, and it couldn't have been more different. The principal there was teach by the book, here's the curriculum that the school board dictated, you're basically just a delivery vehicle to deliver this preformed curriculum that you didn't help design, that you barely know much about, so you have the summer to read up about, and just go. Interestingly enough, student performance was worse. This was also happening in the midst of the Vietnam War, the protests. This is the years 1967, 68, 69. So student morale was going down. The country was starting to fracture. So there were a lot of factors at play, but my mom was deeply dissatisfied with her experience as a teacher, and she saw it reflected back to her in the attitudes and behaviors of the kids that she was teaching, the young adults that she was teaching. So, needless to say, her second run as a teacher was not as smooth as her first, but she had learned something from that. And so, was my mom qualified to start Emerson? And the answer is absolutely not. But here we are with this very large school with, I hope, our happy graduates and happy parents and happy teachers. You know, she was young, but she had a vision, and she trusted herself that she knew what made a good education. And that was inspiration first and passion. Then you get into the details. Then you do the hard work. But the motivation has to be there first. So, as I said, frankly, it's unbelievable that anybody trusted a young woman with a newborn child to educate their kid. But I think once they got in and they saw my mom's vision and her philosophy, they just bought in. And then more and more people bought in, and more people bought in. The teachers were happy. The students became happy. And when parents see that their students are happy, of course they're happy. But my mom's philosophy was basically get out of the way and trust other people to do their jobs well, hire the right people, step back, and let the magic happen. But by starting Emerson, my mom had to trust herself. And that's one of her favorite quotes from Emerson, education should teach self-trust. Over the next 4 years, you guys are going to develop into adults. The next time you graduate, the next time you're at a ceremony being given a diploma, you'll probably be 18 years old, maybe 17, about to turn 18, but you'll be young adults. You'll have plans for college or work afterwards, and you'll be sent off into the world to start adulting, all right? And hopefully, if you've been well-educated, our families and our teachers have well-educated you, you will have a strong sense of self, a strong sense of value. You'll have an inner voice that you can trust. And for parents, at this point, we have to start, from families, start letting go and trusting our children more and more, not step in so much. I think one of the things I know as a university professor is I see so many students coming in to university now with very high marks, but when you actually meet them, they're quite dependent, not independent, not fully formed adults, not self-sufficient, not self-reliant. And I hope that, I mean, look at these kids. They're great. They're awesome. I hope we can all step back more and more, let them find their own voices. And kids, if you find your parents or your families getting in the way and saying, hey, you need to do more of this, and hey, that math homework, let me check it for you. Maybe there's some times you should step back and say, hey, I've got this. I went to school at Emerson. And I know how to do things too. And maybe I will make a mistake, but that's okay because I'll learn from it. So I think that's the kind of attitude that my mother had when she started Emerson. This, I got this. And I think you guys will too. So congratulations. You guys are awesome. I think you've got this. And best of luck in your future. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Today I'm here to talk about my time here at Emerson and my amazing experiences with my teachers and classmates. When I first got to Emerson in first grade 2017, I thought I would be lonely and wouldn't be able to make any friends. The first day of Emerson, I was immediately embraced by many people, including people that are still my friends today. As the years continued, I progressed and gained more knowledge. I created and finished many projects such as the Coral Reef Project, Miss Chenier's Passion Project, Mr. Seymour's Super Fun Design Your Own Country, Victoria's many lengthy but overall not so bad papers, and Eddie's never-ending equations that fried my brain. And all the fun field trips like Mr. Seymour's Tree Runner, Miss Chenier's Camping Trip, Mr. Nolan's Salmon Release, and Tal Usher's fun Chinese field trips to museums and restaurants. I'm going to miss all the fun experiences and all the friendships I've made with my classmates and teachers. And while I won't miss Victoria's lengthy chapters that took months to finish, Eddie's just plain unsolvable math problems, Miss Kwan's packets, and Miss Carol's Shakespeare reading, but other than that, I'll miss everything else. But anyways, other than the treacherous path of homework and projects, Emerson is just the best experience that, and I will never forget. Thank you, Emerson. Life is a journey, and you started me on the right path. Thank you. I'd like to introduce my friend Desmond Beckerleg.
Good morning, everyone. Today we come together to celebrate the accomplishments and success of our graduating class. I came to Emerson in third grade after attending public school until second grade. When I had my visit day at Emerson, I recall how everyone I met was very friendly and inclusive, even though I knew no one. When I started third grade, I recall how the curriculum was very rigorous, and in my first month here at Emerson, I learned more than I did in a year of public school. In my journey at Emerson, I have become ever more curious, innovative, and knowledgeable about so many more things. There are so many different experiences at Emerson that have been some of the most fun and memorable events in my life. In third grade, I will never forget the Michigan Project, where the third grade presented different things in and from Michigan, where me and two other people worked with an amazing model of the Sioux Locks. In fourth grade and fifth grade, I had the amazing opportunity to make and sell things at open market and participate in InvestRight. In middle school, I found so many more activities that I really enjoy and will continue to participate in through high school. I joined basketball in seventh grade, and it became a sport that I had a great time playing with my classmates. I participated in the Emerson Robotics Program for all 3 years of middle school, and it has inspired me to start my own robotics team out of school. But most of all, I'll always cherish the incredible moments spent with my friends at Cedar Point, Frankenmuth, and all the other exciting trips and adventures our classes shared. Eighth grade in particular has been a very unique experience that, through all its difficulty, has been the most challenging but the most rewarding. I'd like to thank Victoria for teaching me that you should always ask questions and that teachers are there to help you. And I'd also like to thank Mr. Seymour for making Quiz Bowl at Emerson a possibility. Thank you to Mr. Ryan for helping me find my love for basketball and encouraging disc golf at Emerson. And thank you to Mr. Wood for making all of our fun math competitions possible. Thank you to all the teachers at Emerson for making my amazing experience here possible. Thank you. I'd like to introduce my friend, Lavi Curtis.
Good morning, everyone. I still remember when I was a nervous fourth grader on her first day of a new school. I was scared I wouldn't make friends and people wouldn't be nice, but my fears were quickly proven wrong. The kids welcomed me so warmly and kindly, and I immediately felt at home and like I belonged. The memory I hold closest to my heart was on January 16, 2020, my 10th birthday. I walked into school to see all of my friends huddled around my locker that they had decorated in glittering, pretty purple wrapping paper. When I opened my locker, I found it filled with candy and my favorite snacks. That was the day I was 100% sure Emerson was the place for me. The tradition hasn't changed since then. In eighth grade, all the girls still always stay after school to decorate each other's lockers for their birthdays. The friendships we have built during our time at Emerson are so valuable, and I hope as we embark on our next journey to high school, we all stay in touch with each other because I can't bear to lose you all. As I look towards the future, I'm excited to enter a new high school. Emerson has prepared me in so many ways, socially, academically, and mentally. The teachers at Emerson have helped me grow, and I'm so grateful for all of them. I learned so much in Victoria's class. It was so interesting, and I always found myself excited to go to it. I want to thank Ms. Keim for being so supportive of me over the 5 years I have known her. Also, I want to thank Eddie for putting up with me for 3 years. I want to apologize to him for always complaining about math, always asking to play Lana Del Rey in his class, and all the other ridiculous things I've done and said. This year, math was rough for me, but I finally learned how to simplify radicals thanks to him. I want to thank Leslie. Ms. Littman, you have been one of my favorite teachers from the start. You put so much work into your lesson plans, and people can always tell. I'm so happy to have known you. Last but definitely not least, I want to thank Ms. Keim. Sorry, that was not the last. I want to thank Ms. Keim, and I also want to thank Kara. She's one of the sweetest people I know. You do so much work for the students at Emerson, and I don't know what they would do without you. You are my coach, and I think you've also been a cheerleader for me and my friends. I'm so grateful for all of you. Thank you so much. That's it. I want to introduce my friend, Shane Redcloud Goldman.
Good morning, everybody, and thank you for coming. I've been at Emerson for two school years, and even though it was only 2 years, I would say this is an experience I will always remember. When I first came to Emerson in seventh grade, I did not know what to expect. I knew that it would be different from my last school, but now that I am at the end, looking back, I had a fun time. I have gained new experience and learned new things. At Emerson, I did new things like being in the Addams Family musical, being part of the student council, and doing track. My favorite parts of Emerson were definitely the end of school year trips. The Ohio trip in seventh grade was fun, but I definitely preferred the Florida trips this year, even though it was so hot. In Victoria's class, I spent a lot of time doing research projects, and I know it took a long time. And I enjoyed listening to Victoria tell weird, funny stories about past students. And I thank all my teachers for being very helpful this year. And they were always helpful when I spoke to them. And I thank you all for listening to this speech. And I thank Emerson for being a great school. And now I'd like to introduce my friend, Max Harbaugh.
Hello. Thank you for the opportunity to speak to you today. First, I would like to thank my parents for giving me the opportunity to go to Emerson in the first place and supporting me every step of the way. When I started at Emerson, I'll admit I wasn't the greatest student. I didn't exactly like the school part of school, which reflected into my low confidence in subjects like math and science. At Emerson, all of that turned around, starting with Ms. Keim and Beth in fifth grade, who taught me to keep working hard on projects no matter how hard they got, from Ms. Keim's Civil War book to Beth's topography maps. They also taught me learning could be fun, like open markets and the stock market game in fifth grade. Going into sixth grade was difficult because of the slightly higher workload, but Mr. Seymour was always there when I needed help. Now you see, I didn't like to ask for help, but Mr. Seymour always helped me feel comfortable asking when I needed. In seventh grade, I was able to start turning my confidence and skills in math around because of Mr. Eddy. Mr. Eddy helped me become better at math by teaching me I can do any kind of math problem if I break it down, check my work, and once I'm done, ask for help if I need it. Ms. Littman helped me expand on my writing skills well enough so that I could succeed in the one and only Victoria's class. In eighth grade, I was able to have Victoria, aka the G-O-D, or the Grade Book Operations Director. She taught me how to research for a paper and especially how to write one. While I wasn't able to acknowledge every amazing teacher I had by name, I would like to thank each of you for helping me along the way and making me realize I do like school for school. Thank you. I would like to introduce my friend, Cole Harms.
Good morning. Thank you all for being here. My name is Cole Harms, and I have been learning at Emerson since kindergarten. My first memory at Emerson was when I went to an Emerson pre-K camp with Miss B. Since then, sometimes I ask the question, what has been the best thing about my time at Emerson? Sometimes it feels impossible to decide. What the great teachers, the good times, the field trips, my friends, it's pretty hard to decide. But I'm going to highlight some favorite things about Emerson. I love social studies. Victoria is always fun. She gets us engaged in the material and really lights up the classroom. Not only is Victoria great, but the homework challenges us too. At first, writing the paper might seem like climbing a mountain, but once we learned to do it one step at a time, it wasn't so bad. Social studies has made me much a better writer, and I see myself using the system that Victoria uses in high school. We've also learned how to study for big tests in Victoria's class, which I personally feel has prepared me for high school. Another class I like was math. I've learned a lot from Mr. Wood. I feel like I can take a high-level math in high school. Because of the teachers, being a student at Emerson has been a great time, but it wasn't just the teachers. All the friends that we made along the way made Emerson a truly special experience. I will never forget my time at Emerson. I'd like to introduce my friend Chloe Hicks.
Okay, I'm gonna try not to cry during this. When Ms. C first started talking about how we would have the option to give speeches at graduation, my mind immediately went to both of my older siblings' graduations. I remember hearing everyone mention Victoria and her class in their speeches and thinking, I'm glad I'm still centuries away from having to do that. But soon enough, the time flew by, and before I knew it, I was sitting in my bedroom at 2:30 in the morning on FaceTime with Morgan while we wrote our papers and freaked out about the fact that they were due later that day. I always thought when the time would come, I would be excited to graduate and get out of here, but as my last days here approached, I began to notice how many things I took for granted. Between whole grade virus games at recess and Ambassador Panera lunches, there are countless experiences I can't believe I'll be letting go of. My time at Emerson has shaped me into the person I am today. Through the warm, family-like atmosphere, mostly provided by Mr. Feldman letting me eat the extra bagels after ESPO events, I've grown to recognize how many quintessential moments from my childhood have stemmed from experiences here. One specific class I have profound positive memories of is Mr. Wilson's science class. I always used to look forward to going to his class and discovering what fun experiments we would be doing that day. Another more recent fond memory I have of my time here is the morning I finished my high school application. I spent my early morning writing it, and as I walked into school at about 10 a.m. and turned the corner to my locker, I heard a surprise and jumped to see my best friends holding cupcakes and a cheesy sign next to my locker that was decked out with bows and streamers. Shout out to you guys. There are many life lessons and connections that I can take away from my time at Emerson, but one of the most important and valuable things is the bond I have formed with some of my classmates and teachers. These connections are what have kept me going through everything, specifically my struggles with geometry, and motivated me to stay resilient when problems come my way. While I appreciate every single teacher I've had through my 8 years here, I'd like to shout out a few. I'd like to thank Ms. Littman for always being there for me. I'd like to thank Victoria for teaching me more than I ever thought possible, especially not to be late for her class when she locked me out. I'd like to thank Mr. Wood for not killing me for talking too much. I'd like to thank Ms. Keim for being one of the best teachers I could ask for. I'd like to thank Kara for listening to me gossip to her 24/7. And finally, I'd like to thank Madame Perouac for keeping her patience with me while Reese and I belted Taylor Swift in the middle of her class. You all have made my time here so valuable, and I'll always be able to take away such incredible memories with each and every one of you. Now I'd like to introduce my dear friend, Amy Pandolfi. When I first arrived at Emerson a short 9 years ago, I was 5 years old with the top priority of playing with my friends at recess. Now I'm 14 years old and I'm filled with mixed emotions about leaving Emerson. We will all have to participate in new challenges in new and unfamiliar academic environments. It's so awesome to look back and reminisce about all the memories I've made at this school. The relationships and bonds I've formed with many of my peers and teachers is definitely what I will miss most about leaving this school. I'd like to take the time to thank people who have supported me throughout my middle school years. First, there's my dad, who always helped me with vocab in the car on the way to school, and my mom, who put up with, according to Carol, my teenage-y attitude. My brother Robert fortunately set the academic expectations so low that I was able to confidently assert myself as the smartest child. I don't want to forget my friends, who I've made so many great memories with and made me look forward to going to school each day. I'd also like to thank Mr. Wood for always doing the New York Times games with Reese and I in advisory, Ms. Hogue for being such an amazing coach, and Salisher for always being understanding when I'd come into class with my homework half done. Thank you for making my time at Emerson so memorable. I remember walking through the halls on the first day of sixth grade while the eighth graders towered over me. I was so nervous about not being able to meet the new standards and expectations I'd be held to academically, but luckily I had the help of my friends. They assured me that I wasn't alone and that they were just as nervous as I was, but as soon as I walked into Mr. Seymour's class, I immediately knew that I would have the support that I needed and that I didn't have to worry about middle school. Although there are incredible memories I've made at Emerson, I also have had my fair share of obstacles to overcome. Unfortunately, in seventh grade, I injured both my ankles due to gymnastics, and I was forced to wear two boots for 4 weeks, and although that may not sound that bad, it was quite the opposite. Walking through the hallways, trying to pick up things from the ground, and fully participating in class was frustrating and tiring. Not to mention, wearing them was also incredibly embarrassing. Worst of all, sleeping in them was probably one of the most enraging experiences I've ever had to go through. It was so bad, I even fell asleep in Miss Lipman's class, but thankfully she just laughed. If it wasn't for my friends helping me carry all my stuff to each of my classes, I would have never made it to any of them on time, so thank you. I know many of us may not show it every day, but we are all extremely grateful for the hard work and dedication the teachers have put into this eighth grade class. From putting us into three cohorts because we couldn't focus, locking us out of class if we were late, and even hiding our backpacks if we left them in the hall, we appreciate all the attention and effort put into this class. Thank you. I'd like to introduce my friend Avery Phillips.
Good morning, everyone. When I started here at Emerson, I was 11. I had spent the last 1.5 years of my schooling online, and in class we had continued to wear masks. The only time I saw my friends' faces were through dividers at lunch. Since then, I have turned 14. I've become class president, I've joined the volleyball and basketball team, I've become a part of the Emerson Ambassadors. And at Emerson, I have participated in 510 days of class, 12,240 hours of school, 734,400 minutes of learning. Among these numbers, I've written many academic papers, read Shakespeare plays that sound like nonsense, I've been taught the laws of motion, and I've practiced public speaking. I've rode up to Camp Newhop, flown to Florida, planned the socials, and worked at fundraisers. I've laughed, I've cried in this school, and I've made memories that will follow me through my next hallways. Thank you. I'd like to introduce my friend Gable Sly.
Thank you for coming. I always thought I would be ready for this time when it came, but in the last year I realized something. Nobody is really ready for change. This isn't just goodbye to my school. It's goodbye to my home away from home for the past 9 years. This is goodbye to all the wonderful teachers I've had over the years, like Sig, Brianna, Miss May, Miss Pops, Ruth, Mr. Wilson, Miss Chenier, Kim, Ryan, and Victoria. These teachers have supported me through all my life as a student, from kindergarten to eighth grade. This is goodbye to the playground, where I spent so much time during the years, playing Groundies, or Virus, or Foursquare. This is goodbye to Victoria's papers, which sucked, but I enjoyed them anyway. I remember when I was in lower school, and I got my foot stuck in the bridge on the play structure, and our old nurse Diane came to unstick it for me. I remember trading Pokemon cards with my friends on the blacktop. I remember laughing with my friends while we ate lunch, and I remember Ruth taking me and Christian to the reptile show in second grade. I've tried to make these feelings make sense, but I know deep inside that they never will. I don't think of this as an end of a journey. I think of this as the beginning of a new one. I might have to say goodbye to this school for now, but I will never say goodbye to the memories and experiences I've made along the way. And for me, that's what really matters. I would now like to introduce my good friend, Christian Weaver.
Good morning, class of 2024. As of today, we've officially survived eighth grade. Contrary to most people, it doesn't feel as if I walked into kindergarten yesterday. But graduating as the younger sibling by 3 years, that equates to a total of 12 years that I've known this school. While I haven't spent that much time here myself, 9 years from when I started here isn't that far off either. For me, a 14-year-old, that's roughly two-thirds of my life. Long enough for me to forget some of my early days here, though I would still remember dropping Big Bro off at the Emerson doors before being shuffled off to preschool every day until I would step in that K-2 wing myself. Upon that day, I would begin to establish some of my most iconic memories of my elementary years as I would progress to a middle schooler at Emerson, some of which include eating together in the kindergarten cafeteria, building water dams outside in the rain during recess, and spending time with our older buddies. They were so cool, or so I thought for the time, as those fourth graders towered over me and my fellow kindergarten classmates. However, that's only a fraction of my memories at this school. In case you didn't know, March of 2022 forced us to learn distantly from our own homes. I first thought this was sudden and unexpected and unpredictable. I did not like it to start. However, I would hold some of my deepest memories of my late lower school years here, like writing our InvestRight essays the first week we went online, and much trial and error with connection issues on Zoom. Missionary also taught me to manage my time despite these troublesome obstacles, as I often would not turn in my assignments. While much more recent, middle school has attached memories to my time here as a 6th through 8th grader, like playing soccer for the Eagles, field trips to Frankenmuth and Cedar Point, aftercare, and Benji making me laugh at curbside every day. And lastly, I would like to thank Mr. Wood for coaching me and some other folks to not ask stupid questions and not make overly obnoxious noises in class, and Victoria. They say to love your enemy, and that couldn't be more true here, as her history papers really taught me how to pace myself throughout the entirety of her projects, instead of cramming in all my note cards the Sunday night before they were due. I've learned many life lessons from my education at Emerson, and now I'm ready to carry that knowledge throughout the rest of my high school career and thus forth. But I will always remember where it all began. Thank you. Now, I would like to introduce my good friend, Quinn Williams.
I've been going to Emerson for 4 years now. Over the years, I've met so many amazing people and have experienced so many amazing things. I loved my experience at Emerson. The school has really helped me grow as a person and learn new things. Emerson has so many different electives and other extracurricular activities to offer, and every single one I did helped me in a different way. When I first joined, I was nervous. I didn't know what to expect. I first joined during fifth grade, and it was during COVID. For the first few months, we were online, and it was very difficult, but it showed me how the teachers are really willing to adapt and help to the students. Emerson quickly became a place I felt at home. Emerson has shaped who I am in so many ways. The school is not only focused on teaching math or science, but also taught important life skills and problem-solving abilities. I found myself enjoying many of the classes from Victoria's class, which has taught me so much over the years. Ms. Trimner, who's over the years have taught me so much about drawing and has always let me express myself. Ms. Littman, whose class was always fun and exciting. And Eddie, who gets a shout out purely for dealing with me despite how annoying I am. I have so much more I'd like to bring up, from all the fun trips we've been on to having fun with our third grade buddies. But I have limited time up here, and most of you have probably already heard me talk enough over the years. Goodbye to you all, and goodbye to Emerson. I'd like to introduce my friend, Albert Wisely.
These 3 years at Emerson have been some of the best I've ever had, ever. I don't really count the first year because that was COVID, and like, that really count? That really isn't saying much because I'm only 14 years old as well. Nevertheless, Emerson has changed my life. I have a new instrument. I play cello now. I do new sports, and I found other new things that I love, and new friends too. Met plenty of people, tried plenty of things. I now try to better myself by surrounding myself not only with friends, but also people who are nothing like me, people who are 100 times smarter than me, and I look at them and I'm like, wow, okay. You know, if I only limit myself to one thing, where am I ever gonna go? What am I ever gonna do? I could never know that I'm actually really good at something else. Of course, once you've found something that you love, you should do that thing. You should go, you know? And I think some thanks, right? I need to thank people, okay? I need to thank everybody that I know, all of you, and all of you and you, and all of you out there. Sometimes I ask some dumb questions, okay? And when I told Miss Victoria how I was about to get my final draft proof, because I forgot to turn it in, my bad, she looked at me, and I think her jaw fell on the floor. So I didn't proof it that way. I proofed it a different way, besides the point. I want to thank the teachers for knowing that sometimes we were a bit of a pain, and that we didn't always know what we were doing. And I think, you know, like I do this now, you'll think back to your younger self and you'll be like, is that who I really was? Did I say those things? Did I do those things? And I probably think that then, like in the future. In any case, it's weird to think that we were only one class in 50 years and so many more years, and a single moment in time can be forgotten in a blink of an eye. At least, I won't forget all of you the moment I walk out that door. Thank you. I'd like to introduce my friend, Morgan Whitcock.
Good morning, everyone. When I was first told I had the opportunity to write a graduation speech, right away I knew I wanted to write one, but I just didn't know what to say. I thought about just talking about my time at Emerson or memories I've had, but I'm going to start with thanking people. First, I would like to thank Mr. Wood for putting up with me in math, no matter how many times I forgot basic things you taught us multiple times. I especially appreciated that you taught us how to use math to solve real-world problems, like animal problems that included how far a snowman attached to a 20-foot leash can walk around a triangular barn. Second, I would like to thank Ms. B for always supporting me no matter what I wanted to do. Third, I would like to thank Ms. Hope for helping me and coaching me through my multiple years of playing basketball and volleyball at Emerson. I'd also like to thank Madame Pirac. It didn't matter how many times I said something wrong in French, you were always there to help me. I would like to thank some of my closest friends, Avery, Chloe, and Lobby. Thank you guys so much. I know you've only been close for a couple of years, but you guys helped me get through middle school, whether it was studying for a test or doing homework together. Finally, I would like to thank my parents and my brother and my grandma. You guys helped me with so many things throughout my time at Emerson, and for that I am grateful. Some of my favorite memories from my time at Emerson are Ruth Wilson's class in second grade, Kim Hughes' class in third grade, Ms. Lippman's language arts and social studies class, the Florida trip in eighth grade, and I will never forget singing No School Tomorrow in the AIC right before winter break every year. Now I'd like to introduce my friend, Lily Liu.
This is the last one.
Good morning. My name is Lily Yeo. I'm in eighth grade, obviously, and it is an honor to have the opportunity to speak at our graduation. Flashback to 2 years ago, in the middle of August, I sat down with some strangers, having just taken my first few classes at Emerson. Suddenly, I was bombarded with questions, feeling like I was in an interview. During the first week, I got to know a lot about these strangers, who they are, what they like, what hobbies they have, and so on. Guess what? Those strangers turned into my ride or die crew. We've been through it all together, totally acing exams, drowning in homework, and hustling to get into high school. Thank you all for the awesome times we've had and the ones yet to come. Another group of amazing people that I would like to thank are my teachers. I remember Victoria torturing us with exams and essays and telling us to randomly count all the things in our lockers and write them down as a way to teach us about the Doomsday Book. I also remember playing algebra with Eddie as a way to study for a test, doing experiments in science class to see if our hypotheses were true, and reading various plays in language arts. I thank all of our teachers for helping us get through challenging moments and keeping relationships with us, even if we aren't getting along with each other. You all helped me try and do new things that I don't think I could have done by myself. Thank you, teachers, for accepting us for who we are and helping us become more. I know everyone here has someone to thank for everything, and for me, that is my parents and family. Thank you, Mom and Dad, for putting up with me for 14 years. You both have always been there for me and have inspired me to become the best version of myself. A lot of my confidence has not only just been from my own, but from learning from you. I will always look up to both of you, even when I'm a lot taller than you. Wow, we finally did it. I can't believe it. This might seem like the end of a journey to some people, but for me, it's like reading a new book. There is still so much to be put through. New challenges, new experiences, and new adventures. Whether it's the stressful exams, the random heavy loads of homework, or the social challenges, all of the things we learned in middle school would be the secret weapon to navigating our way through high school. Goodbye, Emerson, and thank you to everyone, and congratulations to us, the class of 2024. And to conclude with a quote from Tony Robbins, "The only impossible journey is the one you never begin." Thank you.
We will now present diplomas to our graduates. Right about there. Jay Iagari.
Okay, I'm recording now.
Should I go wider? Ziad Alawi. Bridget Afsharian. Desmond Beckerleg. Jack Bennett. Lavi Curtis. Elliot Daly. Alexander DeBoard. Robbie Farhat. Yu Fukuhara. Grayson Green. Max Harbaugh. Cole Harms. Ben Haruni. Naya Hyder. Chloe Hicks. Ben Lawson. Ari Leonard. Lillian Makniak. Reese Martin. Yaroslav Ovchinnikov. Amy Pandolfi. Avery Phillips. Woo! Prashant Rao. Shane Redcloud Goldman. Gable Sly. Braxton Spiegel. River Swanson. Benny Thomas. Drew Warner. Christian Weaver. Thank you. Quinn Williams. Albert Wisely. Morgan Whitcup. Teo Young Massini. Lily Yu.
My dear friends, I speak to you not only as one of your teachers, but somebody that has enjoyed watching you grow up. There are some of you in here that I literally watched grow up since kindergarten, and those people we affectionately call lifers. And we started a new tradition with our alumni program this year. Every student was receiving an Emerson alumni pin, and those that have been here for their entire educational years since kindergarten, when you first started, all the way through eighth grade, have received the gold Emerson pins. If you are one of our lifers, will you please stand up and be recognized? One of the greatest joys of being a teacher and a teacher at Emerson School is not only watching our students from when they're very young, going through all the way through middle school and really finding their own voices and new life challenges that they go through, but also to be able to watch them as they leave here and what they continue to do out in the world. I've had the privilege of contacting numerous alums over the past 2 years, and it's truly incredible the love that has been returned back to us. 2 years ago, I reached out to some of the alumni to be able to ask them if we could be able to start creating a wall of fame. And within 3 weeks, we had over 100 people respond back with information to be able to give to us. This past year, we started an effort to be able to reconnect and be able to re-engage our alumni program. What's been amazing to me is it doesn't matter if it was an alumni that I taught when I first started in 94, or if it's somebody that might have been here when the school first opened in 1973, or maybe I've never met them before, but they live in Arizona and they came up just by chance on the same weekend that we were having an Emerson birthday party. There is a love, there's a bond, there's a connection. They're old friends that I've never met. They are people that, again, we have this deep sense of connection. Then there are the ones that we have grown up with, the ones that are sitting here right now. What I love is hearing the stories of, Mrs. B, you'll never guess what, they stood up at my wedding for me. Or we went to college together and we were roommates. Or I moved to Washington, D.C., and I was able to find some of the Emerson alums. And while we were playing pickleball, we found some additional Emerson alums there as well. Last night, I had the gift and the privilege of being able to meet with two students that I taught 23 years ago. Both of them are now adults, doctors, and have their own children. And what was fun is that it didn't matter that it was 23 years ago. It was that the connections and the relationship that you have with each other are still something that hold us together. It doesn't matter how long you leave here or the last time that we see you. We will always have a fond memory of you, and you will always be welcome back here to your home, Emerson. Congratulations, my friends. We're very proud of you.
Thank you. the pen's in my hand, ending unplanned, staring at the blank page before you, open up the dirty window, let the sun illuminate.
It is now my privilege and pleasure to congratulate and introduce the graduating class of 2024.